Hello everyone. So today what we're going to do is we're going to do a simulation of a seam weld using a spot weld tool in Siemens NX. So what we have here for our example is we have a piece of angle iron and a piece of plate steel that we are going to simulate welding together at the long edge here and at the long edge over here. I do have a chamfer on the back that is for visual purposes that you will see later. So, first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a new Feminine simulation file. I'm assuming you already know how to do this since you're watching this video. We do not need an idealized part. I hit OK. Linear statics analysis, hit OK. We're going to open our FEM file. First thing we're going to do is assign materials to both of these parts. I'm going to use steel. Okay. We're going to do a 3D mesh on these. You can, of course, do a 2D mesh on them since they're plate parts. But for simplicity, I am going to just quickly do a 3D mesh on both of them. I do have minimum 2 elements, 3 thickness set, because I always like to have that just in case. Select OK. OK, very good. Now, the part of interest is the seam weld. So what we're going to do is you're going to go over here next to 1D connection. You're going to go to more and select spot weld. So usually spot weld, you would think, it applies to small circular welds that are done by electrofusion. But instead, what we're going to do is we're actually going to select the long edge here for our first selection. And for the second selection, top faces, we're going to select what it's welded to. What it's going to do is it's going to use, in this case, an RBE2, which is an infinitely stiff node-to-node connector, so to speak. And it's going to put that down right over there. Because the distance is zero, because one part is right on the other, you can't actually see anything. So in the back here, I'm going to do it at the top of the chamfer to that top face. And here we'll actually be able to see it. And there we go. You can see the little green lines that are actually connecting it. If I hit update, it's going to update the mesh in order for there to be nodes at each of those points where you can see those light green color connectors. Okay, that's all we need to do here. Now what we do is we go to our simulation file. Okay, I'm going to turn off 3D collector just to make things easier to see. I'm going to, for simplicity, just constrain the bottom of the plate. And I am going to apply a, say, 10 kilonewton load at the top of the angle iron. And I'll put it in the positive Z direction. Okay. Now, because we had done that spot weld tool, these two parts are already tied together using the actual meshes. There's those RBE2 connectors. So there is no need to go into simulation object type and select gluing or any of that. We're good to go right away. So you hit solve. And it's going to think for just a little bit. And let's see. Shouldn't take too long because these are fairly simple parts. Okay, you could always go into this, you can always go to graphs if you'd like to see how your results are converging. We could see that everything is fine here, so I don't need to repeat the messages. More than that, it is completed. So we close out the dialog box, we go to our solution, look at our result, let's look at our displacement, and there you go. You have a displacement which is representative of the part being connected only at the edge where we selected on one side and only at that chamfered edge on the other side. And you can actually see how the bottom part, if you look closely, is being pulled up at each node as well. So there you go. That's it. Very simple. You got a seam mold right there. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.